This is Reverend Al Sharpton. I love getting the buzz from Yolanda Lattimore. That's why I listen to DryerBuzz every Sunday on News and Talk 1380 WAOK.
Go now to DryerBuzz.com and follow at DryerBuzz on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. It's all about the buzz. News and Talk 1380 WAOK.
To you cowards, then it's gonna be quick. Oh, you made up in the jail before. Suck my dick and all the muckle packs you run with.
Keep the slave physically strong, but psychologically weak and dependent on the slave master.
Keep the body, take the mind. I and every other professor on this campus are here to help you to find, take back, and keep your righteous mind. Because obviously, you have lost it.
All right, y'all. We interrupt this program to get you the buzz behind the buzz. It's Yolanda Lattimore. Hey, what about your WAOK mornings? Are you at work yet? Are you out of traffic as a commute? Okay, it's live. We're live and interactive. 404-892-2703. We need to get some feedback. We need to get some feedback on this WAOK morning. Let me just tell you, y'all have spent the last 24 to 48 hours defending black people a la Geraldo Rivera. And you know I'm going to give you a whole other spin. We got to have a whole other conversation because apparently we don't have enough pushback. Somebody can say something and throw us in a tizzy where we decide we're going to defend ourselves. Let me give you one thing. You can write this down. Everybody grab a pen and write this down because you need it. You need to know it so that you don't ever have to do what some of us have had to sit back and witness this last couple of days. I mean, social media has been blowing up, you know, the radios, the talk shows. Everybody is trying to figure out, well, somebody said something about black folks. Geraldo Rivera went for hip hop, saying that hip hop now is worse than racism. First of all, we've been saying that for the past decade. We've been saying that since BET destroyed a generation when the narrative of hip hop changed to this rap narrative. So how is it that Geraldo Rivera can take an echo that's already out there and every piece of news will flash it out, and now you spend the last 24 to 48 hours defending us? Sometimes it's okay to shoot the messenger. When the messenger comes with such an echo, you might just need to shoot the messenger, and so that you can really deal with the problem. Now, you don't have to agree or disagree, because what it shows is that you getting upset and all hyped up about this right now shows that you ain't been listening to your own people. I mean, we've been saying this since Boys in the Hood became an iconic film, since it went across the nation showing the degradation that black folk were doing to each other. I just think that we as black people need to stop acting like the Falcons and get some defense for ourselves. We don't have to defend ourselves, because the first pushback you should have said to Geraldo Rivera is the fact that Geraldo has been in media for 40 years. What has he been to the story of brown men? What is he? He spent all that time trying to break into the vaults, you know, that has nothing to do with his heritage and culture, when he could have been helping us to understand the struggle of the Latino man. You know, and so I don't understand why it is that we have now gone back into defense mode of defending ourselves when we are, as I tell y'all, okay, survivors of the greatest survivors of an American people. We are, write that down. We are the survivors in the greatest survival of an American people. We are the absolute most humane people on the planet. Anybody ever watch that show, What Would You Do? And the people who always, whenever somebody's in trouble, the people who always jump in is us. We jump in everybody's fight because we know how to, as Dr. King say, recognize right as well as reality. And when you don't recognize right as well as reality, you invite shame as well as violence. And see, the thing about it is, too many of us are walking around in shame. And so, therefore, there is an element of violent culture among us, but there's also the best of humanity among us. When we're going to come back, I'm going to tell you how you getting upset with and about what Geraldo said is actually you participating in the hidden assault on our civil rights. Only one place to get the buzz behind the buzz and to change up the story, help you flip the narrative. They don't want me to do it, but I'm going to tell you all about media. On the other side of this break, news and talk, 1380 WAOK.
News and talk, 1380 WAOK.
Changes. Wake up in the morning and I ask myself, is life worth living? Should I blast myself? I'm tired of being poor and even worse, I'm black. My stomach hurts, so I'm looking for a purse to snatch. Cops give a damn about a need.
All right, y'all, welcome back. It's the WAOK Mornings, helping you get ready for Cubicle Nation. Hashtag Cubicle Nation. Go ahead, tweet that for me. Say, Yolanda, I have arrived. Hashtag Cubicle Nation. I know I'm going to get you all set up in your little square. Because I know how it is to have half a wall, need an extra wall, want a taller wall. I know all about that. I've been there, done that. You know, might have to go back. I don't know. That's why you never burn bridges. And I used to be that person. I used to burn bridges, blow them up, because I'm like, I ain't crossing back over there no more. But anyway, I think you should burn a bridge with Geraldo. And I think some of y'all might need to burn a bridge with yourself, because I'm sitting there watching, and I shared it on my timeline, because that's what y'all want me to do. And if you can go to DryerBuzz.com, that's where you should always be every morning. You should also go to the WAOK Facebook fan page and then hop on over to my Facebook fan page so you can see this conversation. And I posted it. And the thing that gets me upset is the people that I know and the people that know me and the people that know what I preach every day. And I'm not sermon-wise. But the message and the moniker that I put out every day is the fact that you got to have an understanding of media. You got to have an understanding of media. And I'm trying to figure out how Geraldo can take an echo. Now, I'm not saying Geraldo had a point. He's right now. No, Geraldo took an echo that in a conversation that we have had for the past decade when we watched certain television networks destroy a generation of our people by changing up the rap narrative. Okay, we already knew that was going on. We were already taking the medicine. That particular network, BET, they have already rebranded. They've been giving us the best of the show. Some of y'all are watching Book of Negroes. I ain't been able to stay on the channel long enough. I'm like, I can't even do it. I cannot access those images anymore. And I do want to catch the last two parts because I think that gives us a little bit of history that we've not yet seen. See, I was that person that watched Roots and couldn't understand why everybody was trying to convince Kente to go ahead and be a slave instead of asking that brother, where'd you come from? How do we get back there? I didn't understand. I never understand why he stood in the kitchen and Kizzy's mama was trying to cook him a meal and telling him, just stay there and just drive for the master because I need you here. Instead of going, bruh, man, what time we leaving? You still got 8 toes. Let's go. See, I was just that person. I'm that person when I hear somebody say the field Negro and the house Negro, I'm like, anybody going to discuss the escaped slaves? That's me. I asked somebody the other day, because I live on this premise that we are at 60, 30, and 10. And I told somebody, okay, let me tell you, 60% are going to be slaves again. 30% are going to own them. Which one do you want to be? Everybody will tell me they want to be in the 30%, but who's going to then ask me about the 10% I didn't even mention? There's 10% of people that don't have to deal with these problems any day, every day. They ain't got to deal with it right now. They didn't get up and get in the commute. They're not headed to Cubicle Nation. They don't have to deal with what Geraldo says. They don't have to deal with media because they own it. They know what the narrative is. They know that they can change it. When I wake up in the morning and I just drop the hashtag media apartheid in my timeline, every producer in this city gets worried because they want to know, what is she seeing? What do we say? What have we done? I know that I can drop that hashtag and it produces that one of the biggest cable networks is then getting in the ear of the person on air. and telling them, say it a little differently. I know that I've had top executives and local news tell me, okay, Yolanda, we're not going to say black man no more. We're just going to say man. When you ask for it, people, you get it. Let's not let Geraldo borrowing and echo put us in a defense mode of black people for the last 24 to 48 hours. Media has one purpose, and that is to influence humanity. That's it. Let's break it down. M-E-D-I-A. Manipulate emotions, disseminating information, and that A, we just had to sit and work out that A because I was like, what are we going to say? The A means keep you anxious, keep your anxiety up. That's the purpose of media. Everybody, that's what I'm trying to do right now is get you real anxious. You just walked in a cubicle nation. The one thing you need to be concerned about, now you wrote in listening to WAOK. Some people wrote in listening to hip hop. They probably came bouncing in just like you. We heard we came in on some DMX and then you play some Tupac. And it's just something about, you know, and I'm a Southern girl. So I like a heavy Chevy. I like that bass music. I like a drum up in there. You notice, you know, today's music don't have drums. But we are people, we live by the drums of the earth, the sounds of the earth. And when you don't have that, it's just something does to your mind and your chakras and all that. Y'all go Google that because I can't do it all. So I didn't understand us. And 404-892-2703. Here's what happens is when we allow Geraldo to enter the news cycle with an echo and we spend the past 48 hours defending ourselves, we then are participating in the hidden assault on our civil rights. Geraldo has been in media, as I said, for the past, 40, 50 years, 79-year-old man running around trying to take his shirt off, got his own selfie out there darn near naked, okay? And we can't even run for political office because some of us can't run for political office because some text messages we done sent. Okay, come on now. We've got to stop participating in and hitting us out on our civil rights. And what I want to do is I'm going to give you a definition of it. Now, this is the hashtag. If you are social media savvy at all, I want you to go out there and do the hashtag covering. C-O-V-E-R-I-N-G. There's an excellent book. I did a wonderful show on it. And it explains how we participate in the assault on our civil rights. It means that we're toned down what is the most essence of us. All right, let's play a little bit of what covering is, and I'll talk about the book, where it came from.
Again, covering would be a situation in which you had some sense of your authentic self, whether that be a racial self,
yeah.
Whether that be a self based on gender identity or sexual orientation,
yeah.
Or religion, and that society would nonetheless force you to downplay, yeah. Or to, yeah. Hide that.
Let's give people some examples so that they'll understand exactly what it is you're talking about. A black woman who wears her hair in cornrows and is told by her employer not to wear that kind of a hairstyle, and who then comes in the approved page boy Caucasian white woman hairstyle. That would be covering, right?
Exactly. And the instance that you're referring to is an actual case that,
yeah.
Was litigated and in which the African-American plaintiff lost.
Yeah.
I'm also thinking about things like Latinos or Latinas who speak Spanish in English-only workplaces,
right.
Who are fired on that basis and who are also,
right.
Usually denied relief in the courts.
But covering would be to speak only English.
Exactly. So,
yeah.
Individuals who refuse to cover are,
yeah.
Policed back into the norm, and to the extent that they say, I shouldn't have to do this because the demand that I assimilate is not legitimate,
right.
They,
right.
Tend to lose in,
right.
The court.
All right. That is the definition of covering, and that's Kenji Yokoshino, I think. And he wrote this amazing book. It's called Covering the Hidden Assault on Our Civil Rights, and to which I have identified the majority of you as hashtag covering. The majority of you are hashtag covering. When you walked into Cubicle Nation, sister, did you roll up in there with your cornrows? or if you're Hispanic, did you change up your accent? Did you go blonde to try to blend in? Are you toning down the essence of you? The thing that people notice first, are you trying to put that on the back burner so that you can have, hey, let me just tell y'all, I got to give y'all some of these segments. So we're going to let Reggie and Justin come back with us on the other side. It's your segment, Reggie and Justin. They calling in at 404-892-2703. Media. The purpose of media is to influence humanity. You got media. Let's get to influence. News and Talk 1380 WAOK.
News and Talk 1380 WAOK.
Barrett asked him why he did this. Munchen said, well, when I am dressed up in a suit, I get friendly nods from my you know, colleagues and my neighbors in this rich suburb of Virginia. When I'm actually dressed to go work out, then people clutch their purses, don't recognize me, and they back away. And he had grown up in a household where his mother had said, if you want to make it in America, you must not talk street talk. You must dress white. You must not be too militant about your black activism or make other people feel guilty about the fact that you've been subjected to racism. So this family stands for Martin Luther King, not for Malcolm X.
All right, y'all, it's back. It's your WAOK Mornings. I'm Yolanda Lattimore. I'm the editor of DryerBuzz.com. I also host the Sunday show, DryerBuzz on WAOK. Came in to talk to you about media because I'm telling y'all, sitting back watching everybody go into this defense mode for the past 48 hours where we just don't have enough pushback, and we end up, you know, defending ourselves. Geraldo jumped into the news narrative with an echo that we've had for the past 10 years, and it went all through the news cycle. And so, you know, we got to defend us again, and I don't understand that. When you know, who says this all the time? Joseph Lowry, when you know who you are and you know whose you are, come on now, media, one purpose in media, and that is to influence humanity. Break it down. Write it down. M-E-D-I-A. Manipulate emotions, disseminating information, and keeping people anxious with a whole lot of anxiety. I went to see Detroit 67 last night. Everybody is going out to see this play. Going because we, you know, live theater and stage is the last place you're going to get the truth. And I'm sitting there and I'm watching this something that's supposed to happen in 67. And I'm like, God, that could be 2015. Why do we keep inheriting these problems? I don't have to defend hip hop. I know hip hop. Hip hop is running the country right now. Y'all, come on. Hip hop is president. There's a hip hop caucus. You got your Democratic caucus, you got your black caucus, you got your Hispanic caucus, but you also got a hip-hop caucus, because guess what? Hip-hop was a generation. It is a culture. It is not a violent culture. Yeah, there was a rap narrative that came along that tried to, you know, change up humanity and make it all violent and everything like that. But let me ask you this. If hip-hop, and I'm gonna give this segment over to Reggie and Justin and Paul and Lucas, but if hip-hop is now worse than racism, what is country music? Because I'm inclined to think that as they were rolling up, trying to catch up with the bus of the Freedom Riders, the bus that they set ablaze to kill, I'm inclined to believe they were listening to country music. Okay? When they were rolling up, trying to keep people from registering to vote, history of country music tell me they were listening to country music. When a black person tried to walk up into the NASCAR race, you know, and they do a documentary and they talk about they don't want no black people at the NASCAR, but then NASCAR wants to do all this marketing and get black people out there. I'm inclined to believe they, when they in their RVs getting ready to go tailgate, they listening to country music. So if hip hop or this rap narrative of lately, I ain't even gonna allow you to say hip hop, the rap narrative of lately, if it is worse than racism, and I'm gonna tell you, I was sitting there watching the Selma movie and I was thinking, do people who live a violent culture today, do they realize we went through this? And it's kind of odd that the face of this type of violence has changed to what, you know, we've been talking about this. What, name me a country song that tells you what the world needs now is love. Name me a country song that says fight the power. Give me one country song that tells us, that asks you what's going on. Give me a country song that says power to the people. Give me a country song that says I am my brother's keeper. Give me a country song. You know, I when you go to all the political marches and so forth, you never hear nobody play a country song. What, they will play some hip hop. Okay. When a person, a non-black person rose up, usually their musical influence is what, Motown? So if hip hop is it results is worse than racism, what is country music? Because it's got a history longer than. It's got a history as long as all the things everybody has been through in this country. And usually the oppressing people, when Sarah Palin get ready to go up there and talk about Obama being, you know, all this stuff. What's she listening to? She listening to country music. Tell me that segment ain't over. Tell me that segment ain't over. Okay. All right. I promise. Reggie, Justin, Paul, and Lucas, y'all get the next one. 404-892-2703. One more person can jump in there with them. Reggie, Justin, Paul, Lucas, the next segment is yours on News and Talk 1380 WAOK. Okay, we're back. It's your WAOK mornings, okay? Getting you through your commute. Are you already there? You should already be at work. I don't know how you morning people flow with it, but I'm usually hashtag gone blogging right about now. You should go check out the blog at DryerBuzz.com. All the social media you can get at me at DryerBuzz. I promised this segment to Reggie and Justin. So, Reggie, what's your morning comments?
There's a documentary on a station called Link TV. It's called Manufacturing Consent. It's very detailed, state-of-the-art of what the media is, who runs it. I mean, down to the money, the influence, and it. Great documentary. Noam Chomsky's in it. Mm. I just wanted to get people on that. Noam Chomsky and another guy named Chris Hedges. Mm-hmm. Anything by them, great information, nonpartisan, straight ahead about the media and how it's run. I mean, everything, advertising, is called Manufacturing Consent.
And Reggie, let me ask you though, before you go, though, why is it that you think that we haven't yet realized how to exploit media?
That's a loaded question. Yeah, it's not a magic bullet. I can't say that in 10 minutes. That may be a form. It's a lot going on. Really, the access to media has been shut down, and I learned this through the documentary. You know, stations like you, the Black Press, and stuff like that. A lot of the independent stuff was bought up. There are four major players.
Mm-hmm.
There are four or five major players, and they control everything from how much Coca-Cola commercials you see to how many, you know, what you see. Who you see, how they look, what they look like, you know, it's manufacturing consent. It's the war, how the war is spent, everything. It's amazing because I was blinded to it because they're good at it. These people go to school for that. They spend millions of dollars on this.
Exactly, because they know that the purpose of media is to do what? Influence humanity. All right, and we're gonna go to Justin. Also, we got Mark. Mark, I see you there. Mark is in the mix. He's going to help us understand the history of this country music. But let me just go and jump over and talk to Justin. Justin, thanks so much for holding. What's your morning comments?
Yolanda.
Yes.
Listening to you, I got one thing to say. You know what that is?
Oh, Lord, what is it?
Turn it down for what?
Turn it down for what?
Turn it down for what?
Justin, is that your morning comments? All right, Justin held on to tell us, turn deaf. Because, I mean, it's just a conversation. We should not allow an echo, hear me when I say this, an echo to throw us into 48 hours of defending our humanity when we're the most humane people on the face of the planet. Paul, what's your morning comments?
Hey, how's it going? I want to tell you it's refreshing hearing up-to-date messages from you. Every time you call on the radio, you're tune in. Modified Negroes keep on falling for the same old okie doke.
Mm-hmm.
We should know the digital age is nothing but a psychological plantation. So why don't we know what we listening to and what we tuning in?
Well, hold on. Because you know, you got to understand, I'm a framer of the digital age. I've been in it for the past 30 years.
Right.
Okay. But I never saw it as a plantation. I saw it as a way to freedom.
Well,
How did it become a plantation for you?
It's a digital plantation to the one cannot decipher true or false. That's why a lot of people now, you don't have to go to the pulpit to get brainwashed. You can get brainwashed right there in your living room from the digital plantation. But it's in us to know true or false. Mm-hmm. But the ones that keep on calling in, them are the ones that have been brainwashed. Thank you.
All right. And you know, he hit on something. I mean, but that's the purpose of media. See, I use the polite way of saying influence humanity. But there's a whole lot of brainwashing going on. Because the thing about it is, it's about who you can keep in your audience. And I wake up in the morning and I realize, it's like, wait a minute. I control a wave. I control a wave that goes through this narrative every day. And if I don't send out something like, you know, toss those rocks out there to keep my waves going, you know, you ever seen that part where the two oceans meet but they don't mix? That's what's going on right now. We do have we do own a part of this media. I got to get to Lucas and then Mark, because Mark wants to tell us about country music. So, Lucas, what's your morning comments?
Good morning, Yolanda. How are you doing?
Awesome. How are you?
Awesome. I want to ask you a question. I want to make a comment, too.
Mm-hmm.
If someone broke into your home threatening you and your family, and you had a gun, and this person could potentially annihilate you, would you shoot them?
Of course.
Okay.
Come through my door, you might get shot anyway.
Okay. Now, you see how... You see how that didn't require no thought on your part.
No.
That was very simplistic, because what was at stake was your mere survival.
Mm-hmm.
And what's at stake with our white brother is his mere survival, because they know that, and we don't have to look no further than Pennsylvania Avenue with Barack Obama, daddy being a Kenyan and his mother being a Caucasian, they know that we can systematically come through their door and annihilate their whole race. So if they know that we can systematically come through their door and annihilate their whole race, then it has to be mechanism in place to protect them. And people like the media is one of the mechanisms that's in place to correct them.
Right. Let's be glad that they use the media, because they also have the NRA, the Nervous Retaliation Association. They've been nervous that we're going to retaliate, so they've associated. And so that's just something we have to deal with. But because we haven't, doesn't that prove that we're the most humane people on the face of the planet? Doesn't that prove that we are part of the greatest survival of an American people? And now you want to tell us, or you want to echo us, not tell us, Geraldo. Geraldo ain't told us nothing. Now you want to echo the fact that we have said you have infiltrated our music, changed up our rap narrative because you were afraid of where the real hip-hop culture was going. And so I asked the question. I just asked the question. If we're going to talk about hip-hop, then let's also talk about another long-running genre of music, country music. And let's, on that note, let's go to Mark. Mark, what's your morning comments? And thanks for listening.
Yes. Well, you're talking about the country music, and you wanted an example of country music. Brad Paisley has a song called Welcome to the Future. It deals with racism. In that song, it talks about his friend on the football team getting a cross burnt in his yard for asking out the homecoming queen. It also talks about a woman on a bus, a man with a dream. There are a lot of country songs that are uplifting and deal with racial problems.
Mm-hmm.
I bet on your playlist, that you have, you probably don't have too many country songs, do you?
No, that's not.
That shows your ignorance of country music and why you say some of the things that you say, because you've never listened to it.
I do listen to it. There are several channels out there. I can expose myself to it at any
which
time.
Which channels do you listen to?
There's a country music television channel, and then up in the 900s on the cable, there's a thing. But see, when I hear Sarah Palin,
which country music channel do you listen to on the radio?
No, my dial doesn't go that way. My dial sticks with WAOK. When I hear, when Sarah Palin gets ready to walk in, when the Republicans get ready to walk in, I listen to these country songs, and it never talked about. We're gonna go and check out some Brian Paisley. You know, I even listened to the country singers when they had Nelly up on stage with them on Today's Show. But
well,
I mean,
at
but
the Country Music Country
What's
Music
the
Awards, they have black people. They have Darius Rucker, a very big performer.
Three to four people over the past 30, 40 years. And I even know there's a black country singer and she's gonna tweet me. There's a black country singer, female country singer trying to break into.
Okay, and does that say that country people block out all the black country singers, or are there not that many black singers?
Do you like the black country singers?
No, he's fine. Absolutely, he's fine. Country music is country music to me. I don't care what it is.
Okay, and you also obviously listen to WALK. But that's what I'm asking. What is the playlist? If there's a narrative in hip hop that creates violence, then there has to be a narrative in country music that creates apathy. That's what I'm saying. I didn't say country music
created
violence.
I think you're 100% false on that. You're making an assumption that. First off, you don't listen to country music. You've admitted
There's
that. You may listen to a little
bit. There's got to be something in country music that facilitates segregation. There's got to be. Absolutely is not.
You want to believe that so that you've got something to talk about, but that really doesn't happen.
I'm going to try and prove myself wrong because I know that, you know, I live in Atlanta, and I know the media waves in Atlanta are like those two oceans that run side by side and never mix. I don't think there is a playlist. I'm going to try and find. You gave us Brian Paisley. We are going to come out of our hip-hop comfort zone and try to find some country music that will facilitate some of the
name of the song is Welcome to the Future. So I give you the artist and the specific song that
Brad Paisley,
and there are
said, right?
Yes.
Okay,
right.
The song is
Welcome to the Future.
All right, we're going to play a little bit of that before we go to break. But thank you so much, Mark, for calling in. And let me see if we can get one more person in here. Was that Darius on one? You want to play the song and then come back? Okay. All right, so Darius and Rashid, I believe it is. No, is that Darius and Rashid? You guys are going to get the next segment. We're going to come out of our hip-hop comfort zone, and we're going to try to get us some Brad Paisley Welcome to the Future. He was trying to tell the country music listeners, y'all, the apathy is over. We got to make a change. News to Talk 1380 WALK.
When I was 10 years old, I remember thinking how cool it would be. We were going on an 8-hour drive. If I could just watch TV, I'd have given anything to have my own Pac-Man game at home. I used to have to get a ride down to the arcade.
Breaking news, sports, weather, and traffic. We're live from the WALK newsroom on News and Talk 1380 WALK.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Mike Moore. Here are some of the stories making news at this hour. President Obama says to America the fight against ISIS should not be mistaken as a war on religion. At yesterday's White House summit on countering terrorism, Obama said it was clear who this fight is against.
And we are not at war with Islam. We are at war with people who have perverted Islam.
There has been some criticism that he's not calling the fight against ISIS a battle against Islamic extremism.
There is not one day that my heart don't bleed out for all the sorrow.
Tansu Kanlika tearfully tells family members of the victims that he is sorry for crashing into three girls in Cobb County, killing two of them. The judge sentenced him to 20 years in prison. Kanlika is a locksmith who was pursuing a person who skipped out on the bill after hitting the girls. He left the scene. Charges are also pending against the person that he was chasing. A patient was killed early Wednesday morning after an ambulance the patient was traveling in crashed. The accident occurred just before 12:30 on Georgia State Highway 34 in Coweta County.
I think the road conditions was fine. I don't think there was any problem with the road conditions.
Sheila Black was a witness to that crash. According to reports, the ambulance was traveling west on Highway 34 near Chatsworth Place when it ran onto the shoulder of the road and hit a ditch. The patient, 45-year-old Tracy Thomas of Sharpsburg, was killed in that accident. Police said Thomas was being transported for a non-emergency. 536,000 Georgians signed up for Obamacare during the three-month enrollment period. They're among the 11.4 million Americans who now have health insurance under the Affordable Care Act. Americans who couldn't enroll last weekend because of computer glitches or long waits now have through Sunday to sign up. It's time now for a look at sports.
I'm Mike Conti. This is trade deadline day of the NBA, and the Hawks have an empty roster spot with which to play, but that doesn't mean a deal is imminent. Mike Budenholzer says they are not in the market to acquire another big.
I think the bigs are our strength, and the depth of our bigs are our strength. You know, we joke, or in our coaches' meetings, we're trying to figure out how to get more of our bigs onto the court.
The Hawks will play Toronto tomorrow. In college basketball Wednesday night, Duke came from behind to beat North Carolina in overtime 92-90. I'm Mike Conti on News and Talk 1380 WAOK.
Thanks a lot, Mike. WAOK weather sunny today. Look for a high of 28 degrees. The overnight lows near 16. And tomorrow, partly cloudy with a high of about 40 degrees. Right now in Midtown, 16. Time for a traffic check.
Well, you want to take it easy along forward to southbound. We have an accident at the Glen Ridge Connector at this time. Also along your downtown connector going northbound. Still this trouble north of I-20 with an accident as well. And then 85 southbound, south of Cheshire Bridge. Watch out for a stall in the clearing stages. This traffic report is brought to you by Reebok Spartan Race. Reebok Spartan Race is coming to Atlanta March 7th and 8th to the Georgia International Horse Park. Accept the challenge at Reebok Spartan Race, voted best obstacle course race in the world. Get started at Spartan.com. Be one of the first listeners to use promo code Radio10. Save $10. I'm Daryl Allen. News and Talk 1380 WAOK.
The People Station, V103, and the Atlanta Hawks are honoring the greatest Hawk in franchise history, Dominique Wilkins.
Here comes Zeke. He'll break it alone. Dominique,
damn! And March 6th, the larger-than-life-size statue of Dominique will be revealed to the public.
Dominique Wilkins of the Atlanta Hawks, the new 1985 slam dunk champion.
Beginning Sunday, March 1st, all of Atlanta will celebrate Neek Week as we honor the human highlight film. And it'll culminate with Dominique Wilkins Night on Friday, March 6th, as the first-place Hawks take on LeBron James and the Cleveland Cavaliers. Get your tickets now at Hawks.com with no ticket fees. This game will sell out.
Who's bad?
Fans should arrive early to see the state-of-the-art, one-of-a-kind 3D tribute to Neek before tip-off.
Dominique with an in-your-face three-pointer right at Larry Bird.
Celebrate Neek Week. Get all the info you need at WAOK.com.
Get effective relief from the burning and itching of hemorrhoids with Preparation H medicated wipes for women. Created by the number one doctor-recommended OTC brand, Preparation H medicated wipes for women are infused with refreshing cucumber, chamomile, and aloe. Use as directed.
VVA is a medical condition impacting millions of postmenopausal women each year. Symptoms include vaginal discomfort and painful intercourse. If you're a postmenopausal woman between the ages of 40 and 75 and one of these symptoms affects your sexual activity, the Rejoice trial may be right for you. Local doctors are enrolling participants into this research study to evaluate an investigational medication. Interested? Call 1-800-70-REJOICE. That's 1-800-707-3564 or visit rejoicetrial.com for more information or to see if you qualify.
When Jenny and I bought our home, we ignored our friends' advice. We didn't get a home warranty to help protect against expensive home appliance breakdowns.
It was Ken who ignored them.
I thought we'd risk it and cover the costs ourselves if something broke down.
Then our air conditioner died. $1,500. Gone.
Yeah, well.
The next year, our refrigerator quit. Our washer needed repairs, and we had a plumbing nightmare.
Just bad luck.
But last winter, when our furnace packed it in...
I had to admit, enough was enough.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah indeed, because when you get a home warranty from American Home Shield, they pay your covered repair and replacement costs for you, so you get to keep more of your hard-earned money. Service requests are subject to a fee for each trade called. Some exclusions and limitations apply. Don't put it off any longer. Let American Home Shield pay your covered repair and replacement costs for you. For valuable free information, call 1-800-500-7197. That's 1-800-500-7197. 1-800-500-7197.
Tempur-Pedic is the most highly recommended bed in America, and Mattress Firm is America's number one Tempur-Pedic retailer, with millions of dollars of Tempur-Pedic inventory ready for immediate delivery. At Mattress Firm, you'll find Tempur-Pedic's best-selling models that will help you sleep undisturbed and adapt to your body to eliminate tossing and turning. Nothing feels like a Tempur-Pedic. And with Tempur-Pedic's adjustable base, go from lying to sitting with the click of a button. It's that easy. With just one click, you can adjust your Tempur-Pedic mattress so you can read, watch TV, or use your laptop. Plus, buy now before prices go up and save up to $200 on select Tempur-Pedic mattress sets. And for the next 72 hours, this Friday through Sunday, sleep interest-free for 4 years. Only Mattress Firm guarantees you'll sleep happy on your new Tempur-Pedic mattress or your money back. So check your mattress tag. If it's over eight, it's time to replace at America's number one Tempur-Pedic retailer, Mattress Firm. Shop in-store or online at mattressfirm.com. For offer and financing details, visit mattressfirm.com/weeklyoffers.
News and Talk 1380 WAOK.
They burned a cross in his front yard.